Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. Children, as you all are aware that in yesterday's class we had started a chapter 2, fractions and decimals. And yesterday we have done introduction of fractions. What do you mean by fraction? Fraction is a part of a whole. If you will ask from your mother that I need or I want only half of a chapati. Half means 1 by 2, means you are asking for a fraction of a whole chapati, which is part of a whole, which means fraction. You are talking about fraction. If I will ask from you that a child who is studying in class 7 or 8 that is using, or a child who comes to school, that child is only using fraction in its day-to-day life, or it is knowing about fraction, so it is it true or false? Then your answer will be false. It is not correct. A child which is at home only, 2 to 3 year child, that child is also using, mama, I want only half of an apple. Half means that is the child was unknowingly talking about fraction. So what I was talking about, that fraction is not an unknown concept for anyone who is not studying your maths book or whatever. A child who is not coming to school, that child is also using many words. A child is using half of a chapati, half of an apple. Okay, make it more half, or 1/4 of a whole. Fine. So that kind of a thing. Like if somebody has ordered for a pizza, that pizza is having 8 pieces. 8 pieces pizza were there. So each part is 1/8. And a child which is eating 2 pieces, that child is eating 2/8. 2 portions of whole pizza. That is a fraction part that child is eating. So yesterday we have done this introduction of fraction. And already these part of fractions you have already done in your lower classes, children. So now fraction that I have told you, then what are the different types of fraction? First of all, like fractions, fractions in which all the fractions have same denominator. For example, 3/5, 4/5, 2/5. These three are the examples of like fractions. Fractions whose denominator are like, they are known as like fractions. Fractions whose denominator are not like, means different denominators are there, they are known as unlike fractions. Then we have proper fraction. What do you mean by proper fraction? Proper fractions are those fractions in which numerator are lesser than denominator. Fine, numerator are lesser than denominator. These are known as proper fraction. Then we have improper fraction. Fractions in which numerator is greater than denominator, they are known as improper fraction. And these improper fractions are only converted into mixed fraction. Now, what do you mean by mixed fraction? When we write an improper fraction in the form of whole and a proper fraction, multiplication or product of whole with a proper fraction, that is known as mixed fraction. All improper fraction must be converted into mixed fraction in each question. That all the improper fraction are supposed to change it into improper fraction. That all the improper fraction is supposed to change it into mixed fraction, and that is must in each question. After that we have done, okay, one more fraction is there, that is unit fraction. What do you mean by unit fraction? Unit fractions are those fractions where your numerator is 1. When you will be getting 1 in the numerator, that is known as unit fraction. Now children, after this we have done first three examples. First example, that is find the equivalent fraction. Equivalent fraction means whatever fraction will be given, when we will multiply that fraction, the numerator and denominator, with a common whole number, and then we will be getting another fraction, that is The new fraction is the equivalent fraction of two of the given fraction. So by multiplying with the same whole number to the numerator with the denominator, we can find it out many fractions. That is known as all those fractions known as equivalent fraction. Now children, and after that we have finished with till example 3. Now today I am going to start with example 4 and we'll find it out how to solve that example 4. Now what is given in example 4? Let's see. Now in example 4 it is given that Suman studies for 5 2 by 3 hours daily. She devotes 2 4 by 5 hours of her time for science and mathematics. How much time does she devote for other subject? Now what is the total fraction of time Suman used for study? That is 5 2 by 3 hours. Out of this 5 2 by 3 hours, Suman studies 2 4 by 5 hours, or Suman spent 2 4 by 5 hours only for science and mathematics. Now the question is that how much time, or what is the rest of the fraction of time she spent for rest of the subject. So first of all, total time which is given to you, total time of Suman study that is given to you, we'll find it out that example 4. Total time Suman spent on study. See, you can write the statement in your own word. Here, see, I have used this statement. You can write statement in any kind of a statement, means that must be meaningful. What is asked in the question and what is given in the question, the meaning remain the same. You can write the statement in your own word. Total time Suman spent on study, that is 5 2 by 3 hours. 5 2 by 3 hours. Which I can write it. Now this is your mixed fraction. I can write this mixed fraction in improper fraction. Yes. So that will become 3 5s are 15 plus 2 70. That will become 17 by 3 hours. Now time spent on science and maths. How much time is spent on studying science and maths? That is 2 4 by 5 hours. 2 4 by 5 hours. Now again, you will be getting here a mixed fraction. 5 2s are 10 plus 4. That will be 14. 14 by 5 hours. Now what is asked in the question? See, this is given to you, total time Suman spent on study, that is 5 2 by 3 hours, which is in mixed fraction, that we have changed it into improper fraction. Then time spent on studying science and maths, that is 2 4 by 5 hours, that will become 14 by 5 hours. After that, you have to find it out time spent on rest of subjects, that if Suman spent this much time, 14 by 5 hours, on science and mathematics, so whatever time is left, that is spent on rest of the subjects, means 17 by 3 out of the total time which she used for studying all the subjects, out of that, if I subtract this 14 by 5, I can easily get the time she spent for studying rest of the subject. So what I'll do it, 17 by 3. Out of this 17 by 3, I will be subtracting this 14 by 5 hours. So let's do it. 17
by 3 minus 14 by 5. Since you can see this 4 are 3 and 5 both are what kind of a number? That is prime numbers. So what will be the LCM of 3 and 5? That will be 15. Now this will become 17 5s are 5 7s are 35 3 5 1s are 5 8 85 minus now 14 3s are 3 4s are 12 42. So what I will be getting? 85 minus 42. What is left? 43 divided by 15. 43 divided by 15. Now here you can see that is your improper fraction that will be converted into mixed fraction. So what I'll do it, I'll do the division and that will become 15 2s are 30, 13 by 15 hours. 2, 13 by 15 hours. This much is the time which is used to study rest of the subject. So time devoted for studying science and math, that is 14 by 5 hours, and total time spent on study is 17 by 3 hours. So from 17 by 3 you will be subtracting 14 by 5. After doing subtraction of this, we'll be getting 43 by 15. Since LCM of 3 and 5, that will be 15. Since 3 and 5 both are prime numbers, so LCM will become 15. Then we will do the subtraction. 17 5s are will be 85 minus 14 3s are will be 42. 43 by 15. Since 43 by 15 is again an improper fraction, so that I'll suppose to change it into mixed fraction. I've changed it into mixed fraction and I'll be getting this answer. 2 13 by 15 hours is the time which is spent on studying rest of the subjects. So children, with this we have done all the four examples related to the exercise 2.1. So today children, I'm going to start next our exercise 2.1 and we'll see different operations used for solving different fractions. How we can subtract the given fraction from a whole number that we are going to find it out. So let's start exercise 2.1. Exercise 2.1. Exercise 2.1. Let's start question number 1, that is whole number. Question number 1, solve. That how we can subtract a fraction from a whole number, that we will see. Subtraction, addition, different operations we are going to see on given fractions. How we can do subtraction of a fraction from a whole number, that we will see. How we can add two fractions, that we will see. How we can do addition of two or more fraction also, that also we will see in this question number 1, that is solve. Such common question we are going to see in this question number 1. So we'll start with the first question, that is 2 minus 3 upon 5. 2 minus, now here 2 is a whole number. Out of this whole number you have to subtract 3 by 5. Now first of all, the first thing which you are supposed to do it, that if you have been given with any whole number, it means in the denominator of whole number you do not have anything. So what I'll write it here, 2 by 1 minus 3 by 5. The given question I can write it in this way. Now here what will be the LCM of 1 and 5? LCM of 1 and 5, that will be 5. So the denominator will be dividing this 5 and whatever quotient we will be getting, that will be multiplied by the numerator. How we were doing this question? After finding LCM, whatever denominator. Now here 5 is the denominator here and the denominator of this fraction, that will be dividing it. 5 will be divided by 1. What will be the quotient? 5. And that 5 will be multiplied in the numerator. 5 twos are, that will become 10. Now 5 divided by 5, what you will be getting? 1. And 1 will be multiplied by this numerator. 3 ones are 3. Now 10 minus 3, what you will be getting? 7 by 5. 7 by 5. Now just now I have told you one thing, that whenever you will be getting an answer in an improper fraction that is supposed to change it into mixed fraction every time. Now this 7 by 5, since the numerator is greater than denominator, so it is an improper fraction which must be changed into mixed fraction. So 5 ones are, that will be 5. 1, 2 by 5. That I have told you yesterday how to write it, that is QRD. Remember this QRD. Quotient, remainder and divisor. Quotient, remainder and divisor. QRD. Remember that. QRD. Okay children, now we'll come to second question of this. What we have done here? Here you have been given with a subtraction sum. From a whole number 2, you have to subtract 3 by 5. So first step is, I am going to write 1 in the denominator of a whole number. 2 divided by 1 minus 3 by 5. Now while finding LCM of 1 and 5, that will become 5. Now whatever denominator do you have, that will be dividing this denominator. 5 will be dividing by 1. And what you will be getting in the quotient, that will be multiplied into the numerator. So that is same in all the questions, whether you are doing subtraction or you are doing addition. In all that, you are going to use this method. Whatever denominator of the given number, that will be dividing this denominator, this LCM. And whatever quotient you will be getting, that will be multiplied by the numerator of that fraction only. So remember that since this method we are using in subtraction also and then addition also. Now we'll come to the next. How we will do second part, if you are supposed to add a whole number into a fraction. Fraction is a proper fraction. So second part will do it. 4 plus 7 by 8. 4 plus 7 by 8. So here 4 is a whole number that is supposed to add it into 7 by 8. First step, to write 1 in the denominator plus 7 by 8. Now LCM of 1 and 8, that will be 8. So 8 divided by 1, you will be getting 8, and that 8 will be multiplied in the numerator. 8 fours are, that will become 32. 8 divided by 8, you will be getting 1. Then 1 will multiplied in the numerator, 7. 32 plus 7, that will become 39 divided by 8. Now 39 divided by 8 is an improper fraction. So improper fraction is supposed to change it into mixed fraction always in each question. Fine. So that I am only saying this only from the beginning of the video, that improper fraction is supposed to change it into mixed fraction. And how we can change? By doing division. If any one of you is not knowing how to change it, I'm explaining this, you can go through this and then you can understand that thing quite easily. Now 8 fours are, that will be 32. And what is left? 7 is left. Now in this, you have to think about one thing. What? You must be knowing what is this, what is this and what is this. Now this is your quotient, this is your remainder, and this is your divisor. And all these three we required to write an improper fraction into mixed fraction. So how I'll write it? QRD. quotient, remainder, divided by divisor. Remember this, Q, quotient, remainder, divided by divisor, QRD, QRD. So the answer will become 4/7 by 8, 4/7 by 8. So what is the answer? 4/7 by 8. Sometime many of the children, they were doing the addition of this, will be simply they are going to write 4/7 by 8. That is your answer. But you are not going to do with that method. You have to do addition with this long method. Now we'll come to third part of this question. Solve third part of this question. Third part is 3/5. 3/5 plus 2/7. Now, this you have to do it. Now both the numbers are proper fraction. Both the numbers are proper fraction. So what do you require here? Simply you are going to do, you are going to find it out LCM of 5 and 7. Since 5 and 7 both are prime numbers, so the LCM will become 5 sevens are, that will be 35. Since in the table of 5, 7 will not come, and in the table of 7, 5 will not come. So here, since both are prime factors, so LCM will become 5/7, the product of both the denominator, that is 35. Now what is the next step again? Division by this denominator, whatever quotient you will be getting, that will be multiplied by the numerator. So 5 7s are 35, 7 3s are will be 21, plus other one will be 5 2s are that will be 10. So this will become 31/35, and this will be your answer. Now when I am doing this question, I am telling you some of the quick steps which will help you to find the solution. Whenever you are doing addition, subtraction or any kind of a question, by using these steps you don't require to do solution of the whole. Otherwise, the children, they started finding LCM of 5 and 7. And again, it will take 1-2 minutes more to solve that question. But if you will find that denominator of two fraction is two prime numbers, so they will not come in any table. And if you will find it out, two fractions, if you will find it out, two fractions, denominator of two fractions, like one number comes in the table of other number, so that other number will become the LCM of that two numbers. So that also we'll see. Let's come to fourth part, and then after doing that fourth part, then we'll come to understand the other question. So what is fourth part? That is 9/11 minus 4/15. Fourth part is 9/11 minus 4/15. 9/11 minus 4/15. So here solution we are going to find it out. Since here again you can see that 9/11 minus 4/15. See, in the table of 15, 11 will not come. Since 11 is a prime factor and 15 is that. 15 is a composite number. So what I'll get it, that what will be the LCM of these two numbers? LCM of these two numbers will be a product of these two numbers. 15 into 11. 11 ones are, and then this 3 5s are, and then 5 ones are. Fine. So LCM of these two numbers, since both these numbers does not come in the table of anyone, so what will be their LCM? That is product of these two numbers, that is 165. Now that what we will do, 165 divided by 11, whatever remainder or whatever quotient we will be getting, that will be multiplying by the numerator. So here we will be getting 15. So 15 6 the 90 minus here 11 4 the 44. So what I will be getting here, 10 minus 4, that will be 6, and here 9 minus 10 minus 4, that will be 6, 8 minus 4, that will be 4. 46 divided by 165, and this will become your answer. 46 divided by 165. So what we have seen in this question, that you have been given with two fractions 9 by 11 and 4 by 15. Since 11 is a prime number and 15, since 15 is a composite number, but in the table of 15, 11 doesn't come. So what will be the LCM of 11 and 15? That is product of both the numbers, that is 165. Then 165 divided by 11, whatever quotient we will be getting, that will be multiplied by the numerator. Similarly, we will do it with this denominator also, that 165, that will be divided by 15. Whatever quotient we will be getting, that quotient will multiplied by 4. That will become 44. So 90 minus 44, what we will be getting, that is 46 divided by 165. And that will be your answer. So now we'll come to next part, and in next part, as I told you in the beginning of this, that we can do addition of more than two fractions also, and how we will do it, addition of more than two fractions. So we'll do this fifth part. Add 7 by 10 plus 2 by 5 plus 3 by 2. Now here you have been given with three fractions, and you can find it out here, 3 denominator, 10, 5, 2. Now as you can see that in the table of 2, 10 will come. In the table of 5, 10 will come. So what is the LCM of that? Since in 10 comes in both the table, 2 and 5 both, fine. So the LCM of these two numbers, these three fractions, will become 10. See, in the table of 5, 5 2s will be 10. In the table of 2, that will be 2 5s are 10. So here the LCM will become 10. Now once we have find it out LCM, after that we are supposed to do division by this. That will become 1. Here we will write 7. Now 5 2s are 10, 2 2s are 4, and here 2 5s are 10, then 5 3s are 15. What is the sum? 15 plus 7, that will be 22. 22 plus 4, that will be 26. 26 divided by 10, that will become 13. 5. What I have done here, I have cancelled it with the table of 2 to make it into lowest form. That is 13 by 5, which is an improper fraction, which is supposed to write it. This 13 by 5 is supposed to write it in mixed fraction. 13 by 5 is supposed to write it into mixed fraction. So I write it here 13 by 5. That can be written as 5 2s are 10. 2, 3 by 5. That will be your. Since the answer we have got in an improper fraction, that will be written in mixed fraction. That improper fraction will be written in mixed fraction. So that is your question number 1 solved. Since we have finished all the 5 part, and 2 more part will be left, that I am going to take it tomorrow in tomorrow's class. Since both the numbers are mixed fraction, and how we are going to do the addition or subtraction, that we will see. So you will keep on doing practice of all these questions. We'll begin the class from here only, from question 1. in tomorrow's video. So today I'll finish the video. That's all for today, children. Have a good day.